In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this Möbius loop by using Blender's math function. We can find the math function feature in the menu. If you don't see it, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. What it does is simple. The math function converts a mathematical formula into a 3D object. This mesh would be easy to model roughly, but very difficult to model precisely. This mesh was created from this simple math equation. We can fully customize the shape by freely changing the equation like this. Blender's math function can create an unlimited number of great abstract art meshes at ease, and its potential is limitless. This set doesn't have presets, but the next one has a lot of them. From here, we can subdivide, solidify, and so on. This is the best mode to use. The XYZ equations are separated, and this mode has a lot of presets built in. To access the presets, click the Operator Presets drop-down menu. Please explore all presets and learn how they can be customized by changing their setting values. Some meshes are almost impossible to create manually, so any abstract art created from this form will look highly valuable and sophisticated. I'll use this preset example to create a Möbius loop. I have tried modeling this mesh manually, but it wasn't as good nor precise as the one made by Blender's math function feature. One thing to watch out for is the triangle or the vertex count. Also, there's a visible wireframe issue even in the render preview mode. We can turn this off from the object properties menu like this. Let me change the subsurf mode to simple. In edit mode, Alt-Shift select the inner and the outer edge loops like this. Shift-D to duplicate, Enter to settle, and P to separate them. Let's convert them into curves, so we can bevel them easily. As I have mentioned earlier, one thing to watch out for is the vertex count. After subdividing, now we have more than 900,000 triangles. Let's apply the materials. I'll use Eevee with Bloom. Please always be aware of how many vertices are in the scene. If I join these two meshes, that will generate more than 50 million triangles. The curve must be converted to mesh before joining them together, but this will create a great amount of slowness. Please don't follow this step and watch what would happen in real time. My blender is now frozen, because it's generating more than 50 million triangles. Because the initial mesh had more than 900,000 triangles, it will multiply once it gets joined with another mesh. Look at the triangle counter on the top left corner of the viewer. I have added this part in the tutorial, just to let you know. We must watch out for high polygon count when working with math functions. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.